Contendales. Everybody say goodbye.
Bye. Where am I turning right?
Bye. Say bye bye, spring break.
Oh, we need the famous cinnamon rolls.
We didn't get any famous cinnamon rolls. Denny's Diner, where Elvis is in the corner. Or no corned beef hash. That apparently is special every day.
Three-quarters of a mile.
Just saying.
You're not buckled in, Deanna. Again.
I'm not buckled. I had to find my camera. It's very important. This crowd doesn't seem very as excited as we were to leave to come up here.
That one back there should have been. She wanted a cow farm.
We're on our way to the farm to be the farmer in the dell. The farmer in the dell. I hold a dare you. The farmer in the dell. And we looked up what a dell was. Kayla, would you like to tell the people?
Oh my gosh. Oh, it is a small valley surrounded by trees.
Yes. And we had these really cool skinny trees by our hotel.
Well, they're smoking there.
I took a picture of them because they're really neat. I-94 East Ramp. So we are on our way to the farm, and the girls got their overalls on, except Presley. She only had short overalls, and I didn't pack them. So, and it's turned cold. It rained last night, and it's turned super cold. We all had summer clothes. Well, mainly I did, and the girls. So
we turned up at 7:40.
Dawn was more prepared than me.
Yes, did you get their shoes out?
What shoes?
The extra shoes I told you to have.
You did not tell me until we were here.
No, I told you two nights ago that you had extra shoes.
Yes, wrong, wrong, wrong.
Kayla, did I or did I not say last night everybody needed extra shoes after we were at the farm?
Last night, they only had two pairs of shoes. Water shoes and the shoes that they're wearing. So what other shoes would you like me to make up for them?
I guess they have to wear their water shoes on.
You have those out?
Or just not go in the mud and the manure. A good option.
In a quarter mile, merge onto I-90 East.
Quarter mile, I'm already on here, right?
Mouse. I hope we don't see you. Why do we
What do they do on the farm?
They eat the corn.
They eat the corn.
This is how I spent my vacation. Chasing her. Come on. Let's go see cows.
So, who is going to help us take care of those?
Cats.
I don't know, but sometimes
we gotta go see cows.
But sometimes I do work with my calves right now. We're having a real hard time this spring because it gets warm during the day and cold at night.
No, no.
Actually,
the mice are going to be coming in from the fields after we've gone into the farm. Because... Oh,
that's so cute.
Hey, nope. Nope, nope. Hey, Scarlett. Okay, signing. This is what she really wants to get at. That's so cute. Her name's Clarabelle. All right, we gotta go see more moose.
This is a vet science project, and this is about the stomachs of a cow. You all seen that little heifer there trying to lick me with her tongue?
Mm-hmm.
That's how she pulls her food in. Now, this is the food that is from the silos, and it's all mixed together, so it's called a total mixed ration, or TMR. So this is hunks of corn.
Can we eat this?
If you were starving, you could eat this, but you're not starving, so you don't need to eat this, okay? But, so there's corn silage in here. This is gonna be fiber in their diet. There's alfalfa in here, which is gonna be their protein. There's corn in here, which is gonna be starch. And then there's dry roasted soybeans and dry distilled grain pellets. And get this.
That's enough, so concentrate.
Oh my goodness.
A grape?
It's a jelly bean.
Oh,
it is, because we are out of high moisture corn right now, and high moisture corn in their diet is a starch that turns to sugar. So we're going to replace it with jelly beans from the candy factory at 1 6. It works out perfect. Okay. Yep. Has that connection? So they're big, but you know what? They only need to have so many of them in it. So, anybody remember how many pounds a cow weighs?
100.
Okay, so they're gonna eat it, and when it goes in, they're not gonna chew it because it's already it's gonna go down to their first of their four stomachs. This one is called their rumen.
They have four stomachs.
Yep, rumen, foesum, abomasum, and reticulum. While it's in here, it's gonna mix with the saliva. What's saliva? Shit. So it's gotta be super juicy for her to cloth it up and chew it again. And it's gonna go back and forth.
Why?
And back and forth. Because this is back and forth.
But doesn't it go into the other stomach?
Eventually, yep.
So cows are ruminants, with a rumen, but so are sheep, goats, camels, llamas, moose,
deer, and giraffes.
Okay. So it's not just cows that do this. While she's doing this, if she is a cow, she will be making milk. If she is not a cow, and she's a heifer or a steer, this is going to be energy to help her grow. After she's done with this,
what's going to come out?
Poop.
If 100 pounds of food goes in,
100 pounds has to come in.
30 to 50 gallons of water, which hopefully we're going to get anywhere from 10 to 12 gallons of milk. And then how much poop is going to come out?
A lot.
You're right, it's about 100 pounds of poop. And I think we measured it once at like 23 gallons.
Where do you cut it?
It's actually there's a jugger behind her. And while I milk the cows, my husband is going to be mixing feed and hauling manure.
Is it the
road? Well, where do you put the manure after?
Goes on the fields. That's nitrogen.
I
It's kind of like the biggest.
Guys, it's cold here, you guys.
So that we can have it so that kids can understand it. But all together, it's about this.
You want to go and school?
Okay.
All together, all the stuff together.
But do we all poop?
Yes.
Everybody poops. Thank goodness. Okay, so we're gonna go into the barn. Are they gonna be bigger?
Big.
They're gonna be big. Oh, you know what? The tie stall barn, and it's called the tie stall barn because these girls are tied up. So I know who I milked and who I
have. What is that?
Okay, so can anybody tell me where their food is? Right here. This is called the manger.
God, it's freaky.
Okay.
My hands are probably cold.
That would be where baby Jesus was put. Okay, in the manger. What is this?
Water.
So they have a drinking cup, 30 to 50 gallons. On top of their mattress is straw. Oh, she's going poop. So above her shoulders is, ready for this? Her potty trainer. Each one of these girls has to go potty. I see another one. Notice how she's arching her back. She doesn't want to get that tingle on her legs, so she's going to arch her back. If she arches too much, though, she will go pee in her bed. So the trainer will give her discomfort to make her back up and go pee in the gutter or beyond. I don't care if it's on the walkway. I just want her bed to be as clean as possible because she needs her udder to be clean. If she has a poopy udder,
will
anybody want to buy that milk?
No. Guys, that's disgusting.
And that's a very important job. Oh my gosh, that cat!
Oh my god.
Do you believe us? Are you a cat lover or no?
Now, I guess.
Now. Oh man.
It's cold today, so she wants to be with everybody.
I hate to say it, we do not spend enough time petting our cats, but it really doesn't have to be. The white one is the airline. So when I milk the cows, I come out early in the morning, four units on each side, and I'm going to milk all the way down to here, which will take about a half hour. I keep going another half an hour, and then my husband, or if my kids are home, will switch for me, and then they bring more in. Oh, notice scream. Don't scream. Okay, we don't want to scare them. But do we all go pee? Was she going in her bed?
No.
No. Is she trained?
Yes.
So cute.
No. Now, I want you to notice.
It's like a little drinking fountain.
That girl right there is only 2 years old. This girl here is only 2 years old. This girl here is only 2 years old, too. 779 here, Golda. Her head is bigger. She is 4 years old or 5 years old. Did you? Yep. She's close to 2,000 pounds. She's almost 5. So she's still going to grow a little bit more. Okay. So right behind, pardon me? I know the numbers are out of order. The cat. There's a song about the cat came back.
You know that one. We thought he was.
We were hoping.
Okay,
so the cow that we're going to milk today, her name is Harper Lee, and she is a special cow. My daughter's great book that they read. Actually, they had to read it twice, so it was one of those things that it got embedded in their head. So we're going to go over this way by Harper. Maybe it was the cat song first. That's what I'm hoping. I would like to thank you. Every day we're doing it, and I do it while I'm milking. So I'm going to push it off with my boots. And
but I never drink milk again without
drinking. Here's another one going, Connie. So you guys are actually in the poop zone, so I want you to come on up.
Okay, I see all my poop right there.
They do. Okay, did anybody bring their pedicure set? He would like your nail set right here.
I brought my pedicure set, and I brought my clip right there.
Oh my gosh, the cat drinking out of the water cup there. You know, is she just trying to act like she's got a purpose? Yes, I have a purpose. I'm just going to be right here.
Yeah, with everybody.
Yes. Okay, when we get Harper up, because she is so big, she has to rock forward. That's how they have to get up. So it's called a lunge or a bob. So just so you know. She's gonna run forward because that's how she has to get up.
You have to do this every time you get him up to.
No, I just don't want them all to get up. When I come out in the morning, all I have to do is say, get up.
No way.
It's a routine. Pavlov's theory. Same thing every day. So doing the routine.
They know when it's time.
Yeah, but if I got them all up,
I see one with some really good nutters. That one is really good nutters.
Then we have all sorts of laughter.
I let the cats drink him up.
Yeah. I see one with a really clean nutter.
She's
going
to jump up in front of you. She's going to rock. Yeah. Okay?
Watch.
She's going to jump up.
There she goes.
Oh,
do I really have to do this again?
Here we go. She says, I know it's not milking time.
This one's like it.
And then she says, oh, I just got to stretch. She's 4 or 5. She's a big girl. So she actually is making 12 gallons to 13 gallons a day.
Wow. She's 1,000 something, right? 1,000-something pounds?
Yes, definitely. I would say she's probably 1,800 pounds. So, when I milk her, I'm going to hook my milking machine up right here. And then before I milk her, I'm going to make sure that the milk coming out of her teats is going to be healthy and safe to drink. And I'm going to look to see if there's any flakes in it or thick milk. And I actually strip it through a screen, and you guys are going to see that later on. But what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to just squirt it into my hand.
He keeps following.
Oh my goodness, you know what? Some of my friends tell me they think her teat feels like a marshmallow. What does a marshmallow feel like?
Soft.
Is it going to be cold and slimy or warm and soft?
Warm and soft.
Warm and soft. So we're going to just start from the top and I just squeeze gently and look what's coming out.
No.
Yep. She's actually got a little bit of poop on her, so I should sanitize it before we do this. That's wonderful. And I think she's got a cow shirt on too, doesn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Are you a cow nut girl?
Oh, God.
Yeah. Wonderful.
How
about Ava? It could be something else with it.
Yeah, it's true.
Okay.
Do you want to do it together?
I think it's beautiful. Let me see what your shirt is.
Do you want to put your gloves on?
There we go. Oh, milk it for all it's worth. And you know what? That's
wonderful.
Yep. Good job. You know what?
I want
you to do it again.
Start
up again.
I saved it, so I'll save it. Is it in their box?
They're going to live as long as they keep getting pregnant again. So we've had one that was 14 years old. That means she's had 13 babies.
Wow, that's a lot.
That's a lot. That's like an incredible Amish woman, okay? So that is not going to happen very often. But four or five babies.
So squishy.
We can do that.
Then their body just knows.
Well, they just have a hard time getting pregnant, just like us. It's exactly the same as us. And sometimes if they had a big baby their first time or their second time,
they don't want to do it again.
They can't get pregnant again. So they have to have a calf to be able to keep their milk from coming up. Each one of these girls gets tested every month, so we know how much they're worth. And if they can't get pregnant again, and it's just like, whose shirt is that that said that?
What?
Gonna milk it for all it's worth. Yeah. That's exactly what we do.
Ready? Good job, the girl.
Took that cow.
Put my present back. Right there. Carry that around. So when she is ready to have a baby, if the calf is in, hold on. If the calf is in the right position, which would mean that its feet were underneath its chin, that calf will dive out. Really easy, okay? It's a diving position. I don't have to help at all. If by chance there's a problem, what is the mama gonna say? She's gonna say it loud and it's gonna be and we can hear that. So then I would come in to the barn here. I would get a sleeve. And if I had a high school or another helper with.
Okay.
I only have a few. Okay, so we're gonna be doing this for a little bit, okay? We'll pass them around, okay? Here, hold on a second. You'll be mine after I get done with mine. So what we do is we reach in and I'm gonna feel. If I reach in and I feel two feet and a nose, that calf is in the right position. If I reach in and feel 2 feet and a tail, then that calf is backwards. And then I would have to put on another glove. Here, you can do it with me. I would put on another glove because I would have to use my little ropes I have, and I'd have to attach them to the bottom of their little ankles. And then I attach that rope to a walker that I have. It's actually a calf puller. Yep. And then what it does, I'm gonna have you have your other hand right here. It's gonna pull those baby's feet out. And as soon as that baby's out, then that mama's very excited. Anybody else wanna see how far they can reach? The baby comes out because it's really slippery in there. And the mama helps by pushing. Just like when you were born, your mama
pushed
and you were
Sometimes
they do, but not always.
No, they do not cut open the stomach.
Sometimes if you were cesarean, I had natural and then I had cesarean too. So.
Now it's open.
Then everybody reach in as far as it can. Reach in how far you can. Okay, so hold on. Anybody else need to put a sleeve on? Okay, please. Oh, you can't keep that. You gotta share. Okay. So all my little best is to share with Rosa.
So are you going to try and deliver the calf?
No. Okay. Push your hand over there. So after that calf is out.
No, I have to deliver it.
Okay, after that calf is out,
That mama is so excited. She's gonna lick that baby off. And when she licks, it'll be my little cat.
She's
gonna lick backwards, and she licks that fur up.
Wow.
And when she does that, I want you to bounce your knees. See how that works?
Yeah.
And then that calf is gonna stand up. And as soon as that calf stands up, anything that touches the top of its nose, stick your tongue out. That calf is gonna try to catch with its tongue. Got it. So when we go in there, that calf is gonna try to lick your finger if you touch its nose. It's like a nipple on a bottle or like mama's teeth. And the thing is, on our farm and most farms, so
excuse me, Bill.
Those calves are so very valuable that as soon as that baby is out and it's standing, we're gonna bring that baby in and we're gonna dip its navel with some iodine. So it doesn't get sick, it's belly button. And we're gonna put the baby in here. If it's a girl, she'll get an ear tag. If it's a boy, it'll be put in a bullpen.
Do you see bullpens? Then,
no, I don't have any boys right now.
Here's the babies. Here's the babies. Oh, he's so sweet, the baby. You're so sweet, the baby. Oh, it's your baby gal. Baby cow cow. That one got some booty poos.
Okay, when you can't touch one to the other.
Oh, look at that sweet one. Baby, want to pet a baby? That one's a sweet little baby. Sweet little baby. No, don't get in the water. Do not get in the water.
Yeah, you may not like it. It feels kind
of
weird.
She may wait once you wash your hands.
Or get tugged in.
Smile at me.
Deanna?
the cow, Scarlett? Pet him. You want to pet him?
Presley, see if you can take this and get a picture of it petting the cow.
Come here, Scarlett. Want to pet the cow? Can you get a picture of her? Pet her? Can you pet her?
You're on the low battery.
Press the button. She pet you? Did you get the picture?
This way, let's wash your hands.
Take it, Press.
Good job.
Is she giving you kisses? Yes, that's good. Thank you. Come on, we're leaving. Say bye. Let's go.
I cannot give antibiotics because of people's concerns about antibiotics. Those cows' cell count is going to be up way higher because they cannot have life. So their shelf life is going to be shorter. So what they do is they ultra-pasture. Well, they ultra-pasteurize it. So they ultra-pasteurize is the same thing that they do in third world countries where they can put it in a box, in a carton, so that it can be that. But it doesn't make a difference what kind of milk you buy. All of it at the grocery store is healthy, and everything, absolutely everything at the grocery store is antibiotic-free.
What's the difference between 2% and
1%? 1% and 2%.
Because it's really low organic anyway.
Well, the thing is that Scarlett, it doesn't make a difference what a cow eats. Her body is going to make milk the same way, whether she's a conventional cow or an organic cow.
Scarlett.
Buy what you can afford.
Nope.
Okay, buy what you can afford. Our milk goes to Dean Foods bottles for Walmart and McDonald's. Is Walmart milk the same as Dean Foods milk?
Yes.
It's the exact same milk. Okay, so, and is organic milk and conventional milk the same milk? Yes. Okay, but you buy what you can afford. Okay, so 1%, 2%. When the milk goes to the processing plant, the first thing they're gonna do is take off all the fat. If it's 1%, they're only gonna put 1% back in, so it's gonna be 99% fat-free. If it's 2%, it's gonna be 98% fat-free. If it's whole milk, which all of you should be drinking, it's going to be 96 because it's 4%. Okay? My cow's milk doesn't even produce 4% butterfat. We're at 3.75 or something.
I gotta go find your sister, guys.
That's as good as what we're going to do.
There.
Right here, honey.
I know. I can
get her.
Whoops. I'm sorry.
Oh, you're good.
Escape artist. Here's your more babies.